My name is M. Chanda. I am the son of V. Muthukrishnan and nephew of Mr. VD Swami. Both of them belong to the VDS group of companies. And my father was a great supporter of sports activities. He was the president of the AS Basketball Club and also supported me and my brothers for the sports activities. Mr. VD Swami was a connoisseur of music. He supported the cultural programs, music programs in a big way. He was the president of Krishnananda Sabha and also a committee member of Music Academy. Actually, he was one of the promoters of Music Academy. And he was also a philanthropist. You know, he is going to many institutions as a supporter voluntarily. One such institution is Sakra Netralaya, which he started along with Dr. Badrinath and Sankaracharya's support. And he was the original secretary. And he promoted, he bought the land, he bought the loan for the academy, the Sakra Netralaya. And Dr. Badrinath was completely taking care of the technicalities. Now it's a very big institution. So that way he is also supporting the other social activities. Actually, I started a sports club first in the name of my father called Muthukrishnan Memorial Club in 1975. After his death, and we coached tennis and cricket in a big way with the support of the Padma Sahadri schools and the AVM Saravanan and the Corporation of Chennai. And similarly, when Mr. V.D. Swami, my uncle, passed away, I thought I must also have some history behind him, so I thought I should start an academy, since many children of our club members wanted to have a program in academy or Krishnananda Sabha, since we have an association. But unfortunately, I don't want to go for recommendation. So we thought Muthukrishnan Memorial Club can start an academy called VDS Arts Academy and support the children from the age of 5 to 20 in the classical music, instruments, Bharatanatyam and all sorts of classical forms. Yeah, that's a very interesting one. You know, one Mr. G. Srinivasan was always our godfather in many ways. In Padma Seshadri introduction also he was there, and when he started the tennis school where we have KK Nagar Nungambakkam tennis court. Similarly, I requested him, I have been scouting around for some school to support us with the stage, free or whatever. And G. Srinivasan helped me in introducing to AVM Saravanan and the MOP Vaishnava College group. AVM Saravanan agreement was almost through, but then it failed because Saravana Bhava took over commercially, so we were not entertained. So the MOP Vaishnava College came forward when they just started the college. So the entire auditorium was given to us for free use. The light is free, everything is free, and they don't allow others also. So with that type of friendship, it started. But for the support of MOP Vaishnava College, this would not have materialized. We primarily wanted the children to have, and the parents to have, an economical way of performing the talent what they have got trained for. So like music, other places where, you know, got expensive one in respect of especially dance, we give a free stage, free power, free seats, free mic systems, everything free. All that they do is come and perform. For coming and performing, we give 1,000 rupees for the musicians and 3,000 rupees for the dancers. So that is the way it's going on for the last from 1995 to now, almost 24 years. So we'll be celebrating our 25th year next year. Yes, primarily, you know, the initial stages, the communication about this facility was not, it was finding difficult, but we created a website, and then we informed the headmaster, principals and others, headmasters of the schools, and slowly people started coming. As the footfalls, you know, comes in, the voice moved out, and then a lot of people are coming now. In fact, there is a demand for dance, where we give one program per day for 3 days in a week, and we conduct throughout the year, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and 1 week we do program of music. There also there is a competition in space requirement. Now after 24 years, that we find there's a lot of children coming in. We have so far have about 3,500 children performed here. Now 3,500 programs, and the registered student artists are about 2,700. So we have pakka registration and records computer system, and website is loaded with all weekly programs and daily programs. Yes, that's actually a great pleasure that we get out of running this day in and day out and every week, weekends, primarily because some of the artists who learn over a year or 4 or 5 years in the music and dance, they approach us for performance stage. We have collect their application, we have a system of application, interview, and after selection they are given a chance. And like that, there are a lot of children who have come up, and I agree there are a lot of fallouts. Many of them don't turn up after performing the first program. But there are aspirants who come repeatedly every year because they are given a chance every year once. And the people who have come out successfully are Guru Charan, Vasudha Ravi, Balamurli Krishna, like that. And a lot of leading artists today have all come and did the first program in our academy. So it has given help to some of the artists in the field of dance, and a lot of violinists, mridangists, who just learned, but all these years they have been going down the drain, and after that they go for education or employment or married. Whereas here, you know, they are having a future. So that is how we are satisfied. We get a lot of credential letters regarding this. No, actually in the tennis and the arts academy, there are a lot of people coming and approaching, offering the space. But unfortunately, we don't want to dilute our time. And if we go out like that, you know, we will not be concentrating on these two academy and also in this sports field. So we want to concentrate here in a limited way. Since everything is free, excepting this tennis coaching, we find that economically we are able to manage now. We do not like to have any issues on the financial side. So we stop here. We don't want to expand too much. Yeah, the academy of course was conceived by me and my another friend, but I would like this to continue for longer. So what we are now creating is a corpus whereby it is run automatically, because we are spending almost 1 lakh rupees every month. But these are all coming from my tennis club, my friends, my donations from my companies. So it's able to sustain. But in the longer run, we can increase the scholarship amounts to the students, and find that it runs for automatically by itself. So we are trying to create a corpus. So it's going on, activities going on. We have some about 15 corpus now. We hope further corpus will get to. Yeah, Muthukrishna Movie started in, as I told you, in 1975, after my father's death. And we were having tennis courts in Ramakrishna Mission and cricket coaching and all that. But later on, it expanded in a very big way into a tennis academy in 1987 with the support of YG Parsaji, who passed away today. And it was really a good thing that happened, that we are able to have a nice place for carrying on our tennis training. And subsequently, when it happened that we had to go to the cultural program, we got the VDS Arts Academy in MOP Vaishnava College. So we thank these two institutions, MOP Vaishnava College and this one, even though AVM Saravan institution has left out our service. Even the corporation land has been taken away. So those two are, we thank them also. For some 10 years we have been able to use that facility. MOP Vaishnava College, actually, you know, they started the college in 1994, and my friends there are Mr. Haridas, who is the secretary of the college, and also Vengadathan, who was the principal. So Mr. G. Srinivasan of Aerocool was a friend of us, so he introduced them, and then a lot of committee members are known to us otherwise through our business. So that way it became easy, and the college is so excellent that they give a fine education and the cultural program, sports program facility to the students. And we support them on the cultural side. And we give a free stage to them. All our equipments and facilities, what we have in that place invested here, they're all given to them for their use whenever they have a program. But otherwise, they don't collect any money and they don't collect any electricity charges. But we do give them some scholarships in the school day, college days. sometime 50,000, sometime 1 lakh per year. But that is support we give to them ultimately. We have 2,700 children registered, artists registered, who are good, really good, because they have gone through that selection process. And some of them have performed one time, some of them perform 10 times, like Guru Charan performed more than 8 times. So total program we have done is about 3,600, of which about 900 are dance programs and the balance are music programs, instrument programs. Yeah, that is necessary because they have to carry for the future. So what we do is we have a process of chief guests for different programs. So the parents arrange that. So the chief guests are invariably from some sabhas or some academy or something. So they come and watch. So there itself the engagement takes place between them. Otherwise, Mr. Ramji and Karthik Fine Arts, Krishna Sabha and Music Academy, they come and collect the list from us of the selected best performers, and they try to give a chance in these slots of noon slots in the annual programs. So that's where they start picking up their name. Like that only, as I told you, Guru Charan, Rasdharavi, Balamukhi Krishna, and so many others have come up through that process only. No alumni club, but these elders come for our anniversary programs. That is how, you know, they get to know, I mean, regenerate our, what you call, our energy. The old people should be there to give us the strength. As I told you, you know, this is, the funding is one of the biggest difficult part. So initially, we bought furnitures, all the thing, you know, and then supplemented the whole thing later through our own funds. So the large donations from my company and from others. And also monthly programs are made out of our club, tennis club funds, our company's donations, and also from sponsorships. And we are able to sustain it, there's no problem. Yeah, I mean, this is just a motivation. When I started this cricket club in the name of my father, and the tennis club, so I thought I should do this for this music also through for my uncle. But all these are charged up because of my friends around who are in the club are also like-minded, and their support also has helped me to carry on with this development. But really it is a great name. Even if my business is doing well or not, these things are going very well. As I told you, we don't want to expand too much because some of the key members of the committee are already old. So we would like to keep them, maintain the same operation, possibly create a corpus whereby, you know, it can sustain for itself to some of the youngsters who wanted to follow our principles or whatever their interest is. And my father was so good that, you know, he sent one of my brother for tennis coaching for 100 rupees per month in 1960s. So Rama Rao was his coach. So like that, you know, he used to spend. For his basketball club, is to donate every month, every year. So that way, you know, I also got interested. I used to play basketball, volleyball, tennis, cricket, coco. I was the team leader for almost many years in all my school days. Of course, in college days, I left everything. And my uncle, Mr. V.D. Swami, is really a great man who supported my father and my family. And he's a great connoisseur of music, and he funded a lot of club academies like Krishna Sabha and Academy also. And Music Academy introduced all the ministers and big shots, including businessmen, along with T.T. Vasu. So it came up as a T.T. Krishnamacharya auditorium. And with Shankaran Netralaya, part of it is very, very creditable for him. And that institution, you can't believe, has grown to such an extent now. But I know very well, in the same building, we hosted the office first year. The original registration is here only. Mr. Swami funded the whole thing initially. And Mr. Dr. Badrinath was just returned back from America. Mr. Swami said, "You are not going back." So he took him to the Shankaracharya and made him stay back in India and service the Indian community. And that's how it started. Then after a few years, after his death, Mr. Balaji, my brother, was the treasurer, come secretary, and he also passed away. And I thought he should create some sort of a memory in his institution. So I requested Dr. Patinath that you have to do something for Mr. V.D. Swami. So he created a biggest auditorium. He named it as V.D. Swami Auditorium. It is still there. And there is a big function in which many stalwarts participated. And Dr. Patinath spoke very high of Mr. Swami and his association. And in fact, he said he got the first appointment letter from Mr. V.D. Swami as a secretary. So that way, the institution has grown, because Dr. Patinath is a very simple, nice person. He doesn't command, he has to respect his position. And Mr. Swami really supported that institution. And the way it is there, I will say, having watched it through my eyes, it is Mr. Swami and Mr. Dr. Patinath who created this institution. And it is greatly benefiting everybody, including my own families.